Hello my dear students and friends, welcome to my session on SolidWorks in 21 days. We are on day 20. In today's session, it is going to be a demo session only, right? I'm not teaching anything, but I'll be telling you how we can develop real product using SolidWorks software. So that means it's a real example I'm showing you now. So it is an assembly, a real product, nothing but a math compass. Okay, now I'll show you the real product. Now this is the math compass that we developed. For that we use the software, SolidWorks software. Let me open my software now, my product now. Where is the assembly file? Yes, so this is the assembly file. So this is the product that we developed in SolidWorks. Okay, so you can see the intricate details actually. You can see the intricate details. Here, I'll tell you, we developed a injection molding die for the knob part, this pin arm part, this lid arm part, this cap. That is 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we made injection molding die for these things. That means there is another set of assembly for each and every part. The knob, we developed a die separately using the same software, using SolidWorks. So again, that's a very big thing. Okay, let me see whether this is there in the, yeah, die for the project is also there. Let us see that. Pin arm, yeah, die part is also there, but we'll restrict ourselves more, maybe only with this one. Okay, then the screw and the nut are the standard parts. These are the standard items purchased directly from the market. The pin is purchased directly, we haven't made. Then the lid mechanism, let me, inside it there is a lid mechanism with the cap. It has been purchased separately from a OEM supplier, original equipment manufacturer suppliers, right? So this is how we made. Again, you see the functionality. Now if I move the right arm, the left is moved equally. Left is moved equally. In assembly, already we saw in one of the sessions that using the symmetric mating condition, we can achieve this equal opening or closing. Okay, so theoretically that is okay, but practically how to make it? For that, let me remove this one, let me hide this one. Now we provided a gear here, so this gear will always make the left and the right arms, the pin arm and the lead arm, at equal angles. So the gear is a key. The gear is a key, right? So that is very, very important. So like that, if you see any product, mostly the mechanical mechanisms, the mechanical things are very important. For that, if you add, of course, this is not having any electronics, but if you add electronics, you can see a good product. That's it. Even if you take a watch, a quartz watch, the entire thing can be is modeled in mechanical CAD software only. Then For the electronic item, they go for electronic, and for functionality, functioning point of view, they add the necessary electronics for that watch, right? Something similar to that. Now let me show the knob also. Okay, if you see the you can see the gear now. Now you see the gear is functioning. The gear is functioning. Okay, so this is how we developed the setup. Now here let me open one particular one file only for information. Let me open the revision 2 file. So then you will understand how we made this particular part. If we take this part, this is the lead arm, the different views of the lead arm. Okay, so okay, let it be like this. Now I roll back, so it has these many features. It has these many features. Let me roll back. So then you'll have an idea about how I progressed. So this is the very first, let me zoom in. Okay, so this is the first one, isometric view and this view. Then slowly I'm adding more and more feature. I'll be showing only the back view and the isometric view. Okay, again I cut, a hole is cut, made, a gear is added, the gear added on this side, one side, gear is on the other side. I have to do this way only because I have to add, I have to mesh this with the pin arm, you know. So if I go this way only, assembly will be proper. If I have a gear teeth straight away for the full thickness, it is not possible for me to mesh it actually. Okay, so that is the thing. Then small cut is made, fillet is made, a curved is loft introduced. Okay, a small cut on the other side. Then this side also a cut is made. So small projection, small piece this way. Then loft here. See that? Here you see that? Then the rib like thing. Again, I'll roll back and come back again. Then mirroring on this side, sorry, mirroring on this side. So actually this is the pin arm. From that I'll be getting a lead arm because both the things must be symmetric, right? So I'm creating the body for the lead mechanism to seat. Now a hole is made here. So we have joined this portion with this one with a small rib, some filleting, cut a 0.7 lead we'll be using. That's why we added 0.7 here. So like that, small things we added, you know. It is mainly to reduce the volume of the material required because the product cost must be less, you know. So that is why I use the wrap command to add some adding. These are all some for the look purpose only we added all this. So this is how we made the each and every part. Let me show it on one side. I think this side you can see that 0.7. Okay. So let me close this one. Then okay, we'll see how the lead arm may be. The die for the lead arm, assembly of total die for the one particular part. The cavity is not shown here, but except the cavity, all the other plates we have introduced actually. Okay, I think that is on the, this is the ejector plate, so the cavity is not shown here. Let me see whether the cavities I introduced in the pin arm at least. No, cavity is in some other file actually. We have to insert the pin, you know. So for that, the one more insert, it is something we call it insert member. Okay, so pin has to be inserted in these holes, then it will be closed. It will be closed this way. If we inject, the pin will be automatically inserted while injection is made, right? So this is how we made all the other parts. Then we'll see about this one, the image again. This is the product. We'll see the other one. Here you could see some ejection mark also. You see small circle you could see. This circle you could see. Yeah, here it will be clearly visible. There is a circle. These are the ejection marks. Now you see here, these are the ejection marks. Okay. So here the logo is not clearly visible. Maybe in the previous thing the logo somehow it is visible. Okay, then we'll see this in action. So it is a product. So this is how we developed some product using the SolidWorks software. So again, it is a demo session only, but this demo session will give you a confidence that yes, using the software, we can not only do some theoretical work, also a real product development, we can do it. Okay, hope you got some information about how we can make the real product using SolidWorks solid software package. Okay, so that's it for today. Subscribe my channel and inform this to your students and other friends and faculty members, so then they'll also get some inputs through my session. Thank you.